point of the set for Del Potro to save one of those match points.
Game, set, and match, Federer. 3-6-1. 6-3.
As you'd expect, Todd, a pretty muted celebration from Federer. But the performance was quite vocal.
Well, he answered any critics about how he was feeling after that comeback against Thomas Berdych, where he was down 2 sets to love. It was Roger Federer at his absolute best. And in the next round, the semi-finals, he'll take on Andy Roddick. And I promise you, he won't be too unhappy about that draw, because his head-to-head with Roddick, you mentioned earlier, is very, very good on occasion. Andy Roddick there in a Wimbledon final talked about the fact that he'd thrown everything at Roger, including the kitchen sink, and wasn't able to beat him. So hopefully he's gone out and bought some homewares and various things, and he can have a good crack at it in the semi-final. But here is Jim Courier, just to see what the Fed thought about his own performance tonight.
Well, Roger, you're now into your 19th consecutive semifinal in a major, which is a record by a long shot. So congratulations, first of all. But I have to believe that you're playing a player like Juan Martin, who's a top 10 player. You couldn't have ever expected it to be this much in your favor tonight.
No, well, first of all, I'm happy to be in the semis. It's a, like you said, it's a great record. I'm very proud of it, but it doesn't earn me any Grand Slam wins yet. But I played great tonight, you know, and like you said, I do not expect a result like this. This is not usual. I don't think Juan Martin was at his very best tonight. Otherwise, obviously, the fight would have been much more. But for me, it's a fabulous effort. I'm delighted, and I hope I can keep it up.
Well, it was delightful to watch for a lot of reasons. You know, in a match, when it's a tough match, you know, you play tough. You maybe don't show as much of the talent that we know you have, but tonight you hit some ridiculous shots. I mean, these drop shots, these touch volleys. I mean, at a certain point, did it feel like it was just an exhibition for you, or you're showing off a little bit?
If only it was that easy, right? No. Look, I mean, it was close, I thought, in the first set, you know, it was, I don't know, you know, maybe one break, and then all of a sudden, you know, you kind of run away with it, and you start the second set well, and you start reading his serve, you start reading the plays more and more, and because you're leading, you can take more chances, and, you know, whereas in the last match, I had to struggle so much to find rhythm, tonight came by itself, and I think then when all of a sudden it clicks, you know, it's a nice feeling, you tried out a few things, and they all seem to work, and then he goes down, I go up, and then the difference is huge. So it's a good thing sometimes.
Well, last time we were out here, I put some trivia to you. I asked you who was the last player that you'd come back from 2 sets to love down against, which was Rafa, and you didn't know the answer. So I'm gonna give you another shot tonight, okay? In quarterfinal action, this is by 4 games your best result. You beat a player, he got 7 games against you, and he's from Argentina. I want you to think about it and tell me if you remember who it was. In the quarterfinals, who was your biggest victory against besides tonight?
I played so many matches, you know, in my career.
He's from Argentina, come on.
I mean, we got no band in, and we got, who else we got from Argentina? They have no players, right? No, I'm just kidding.
You got it right. It's Nalbandian. Now, can you tell me when it was?
Was that US Open?
Yes.
All right.
What so, year?
One of the years I won.
Yeah, 2005, correct. Correct. Okay, so you have a text message, buddy. I think we all know there's this guy named Eldridge, but I think his a professional name that he goes by is Tiger, right? Have you heard from Tiger in this tournament? Has he been sending you any text messages?
Well, is he listening? I don't know. I mean, it's only between us, so it's okay. Yeah, so it's fine. It's not. Okay. Yeah, he wished me good luck, and he congratulated me after the first round.
Nice.
That's it.
No more.
Well, okay. Well, that's good. Now, have you ever played tennis with Tiger?
No.
He calls me
I have.
Okay. Did you beat him at least?
I'll say this about Tiger. As a tennis player, he's a heck of a golfer. Well, you both are chasing some serious records. You're now in the semifinals. You have a tough matchup. If you win this tournament, you would tie Pete Sampras, but there's a lot of work ahead of you. You have Andy Roddick, who played a great match today. I'd love to get your thoughts on that one and also what the rest of the tournament may look like on the men's side.
No, I mean, look, I think it's been a fantastic tournament so far. So many seeds have come through. It's been actually exciting for me to watch as well. You know, there were some great matches the last few days, and it's always fun here down under, you know, to play in the first Grand Slam of the year. And it was nice to see the top guys coming out so strong in the first Slam of the year. Now, playing Andy, obviously, it's always nice. You know, we've known each other since a long time. We've had some big matches over the years at Wimbledon in the finals, at the US Open in the finals, here in the semis. So we've played some big matches against each other, and it's always a pleasure to play against him because he brings such energy to the court with his serve and his a character, you know. And it's nice playing someone who's my age, kind of, you know. Everybody's so young these days that it's nice, you know. It's nice to see Andy doing so well, you know, over so many years. People sometimes don't give him enough credit, I think, you know, because he's hung in there for many years, and that's why I'm really happy he won today.
Well, we look forward to that match. I have one more thing. It's not really a question, it's more of a statement, you know. They tell me to make sure you're standing on that corner when we do that interview, but they also say if he goes back, you have to go back with him. Why are we here? We started up there. What are we running from?
Well, the camera's too close. I'm scared of them, you know. So I thought here we're a little bit more safe, but no. I mean, I always like doing interviews with you, Jim. I'm not running away from you.
I appreciate that. Well, can you do me a favor? Can you send us out now? Can you say thanks for coming? It's been fun, and let's take it to a commercial break.
Yeah, let's do that. It's almost 11:45. It's time to go and sleep now, guys. So thanks for staying so late, and I'll see you tomorrow, guys. Channel 7. See you later.
Roger Federer. He's all right, this guy.